this on the right hand side. So on this road, actually guys, the maximum speed you can have is 60-70 kilometers per hour. In some stage when we have no traffic, we can make it up to 90, but that's it. The roads are not that good. There are a lot of bumps and very, very bad traffic. So even if you have big powerful motorcycle, you cannot ride it here. So for example, today we start at 11:30. Now it's 4:30, which is 5 hours, and for 5 hours we've got only 250 kilometers, which is 50 kilometers per hour average speed. That's it, you can't get more. Right way? Go. Now we're gonna face, I guess, the traffic to Ravapinau, or what was the name? Man, beautiful sunset. Look at this. I think that we are approaching Islamabad. Good, because in about no more than half an hour it will be dark, which is not so good. Big difference here. Huge boulevards, free lanes, and so far everybody stay in the lanes, use the indicators. Not bad at all. Faith, unity, discipline. All right, nice. The rickshaws are very modern here. Look at this. This is how you asking for directions. All right. Finally, we found a hotel, Islamabad Inn. This is the hotel. I hope they will have rooms. Alright. We have for today 310 kilometers for 6-7 for almost 8 hours. 300 kilometers for almost 8 hours. So you cannot just go fast here the way you like. Everything is very slowly. Good morning, another day, another adventure. And we stayed in this hotel, Islamabad Inn Hotel. I cannot really recommend it, not good at all, but it's all right. So now it's 7:30 and from today we're gonna start the interesting road to the north. And I hope that we'll have a great time there. Alright. All good. We need to find ATM and petrol station to refill the tanks. Then we can go. Safety first. We just left Islamabad on the way north. We did not plan it to stay in Islamabad last night, but because the day before we start very late, around 11:30. So it became dark and really bad traffic, and we decided to spend the night in Islamabad instead of trying to get out of the city and then find another town, because these roads during the night are not really safe. I mean, from the technical point of view, because in some places they are really bumpy, not so good, and if you cannot see well, it could be really dangerous. Anyway, we spent the night in Islamabad in one hotel, and now early morning. Now it's 8:30 already, but we left about 7:30. We filled the tanks, and I'm very happy with this bike. For 330 kilometers, it used only 10 liters. It's less than 3 liters per 100 kilometers. Very, very economical bike, and the maximum speed I can hold it's no more than 90-100 kilometers, but actually, I don't need more here. The usual stuff: traffic, cars, rickshaw, buses, minivans, motorcycles, trucks. Good man. At least he did it with indicators, because usually they don't do. It is definitely very different and strange right here. These are the local taxis, I told you many times. Motorcycle with drive shafts and two wheels on the back, 150cc. forget now how many people we've got here on this truck and how they travel. Safety first. Just decided to stop. It's all right. It's normal. If he need to, what can I do? Look at now this guy. Stay right in the middle of the road. Right in the middle of the road. All right. So guys, this is basically what is to ride around Pakistan. And this is actually something like highway, because it's one way. There is another one on the other side, so it's not a two-lane road. Out on the street. Now everything is start to changing. The mountains are on the right hand side. We have this green tunnel. I love that, guys. Hey, to come here the last 50 kilometers from today, and about 350, about 400 kilometers from Lahore to here, was such a interesting ride. I will not say nice, but it is interesting. You just cannot believe what you are seeing. It's crazy traffic, crazy type of vehicles. Everybody do what he or she decided to do. No regulations, no rules. It's just madness. But from here now, we're gonna have this nice road and green everywhere. Good, I look forward. Now it's already like a different country. And we are not on the highway anymore. It's just a double lane road with turns. Good. The asphalt actually is very slippery, very very slippery, because of the dust, because maybe of the possible oils and stuff like that. So it's not really good idea to tilt too much or to test your motorcycle possibilities. Assalamu alaikum. Yeah. All right, all right. So actually they were very friendly, they asked us where we're going, what we're gonna do, stuff like that. No problems whatsoever. Absolutely good. Just 1 second. Just curious who we are, where we're going and stuff like that. It's good to all of these checkpoints to stop and speak with them and talk with them and show them your passport. This is what one of any friends suggested last night, because after this area, when we start to climbing Karakum Highway on the way to Gujarat border, to Chinese border, they actually contact the next post that you are coming. So if you are not coming, they will go back for you to looking for you. Here is fine because the road is very safe, but a little bit later the road is very steep and you can crash, and if you are not go to the next post, they will go to looking for you. Oh, now we have a camel here.